just didn't use the word commitment, but you used the word we are plugging ourselves to a socket. Yeah, like that. We are going to plug ourselves, meaning that everything that we do, it is gonna come like you get my point.
Amen.
And iron, if it has to function, it's taking power from the socket, and then it will function. If it's not plugged there, there is no power. It might act up, but there is nothing. You get my point.
Amen.
So we have to commit ourselves. We are going. We have to plug ourselves, meaning that everything that we are gonna talk, everything that we are gonna do, every action, it is going to be. It's a channel. It's God, and then we act. You get my point?
Amen.
This is what Jesus was doing. He said, everything that I say, it comes from the Father.
Yeah.
Because he plugged himself. He had a commitment with God. He was one with God.
Amen.
Meaning that as he is, so are we. So let's go and we plug ourselves. Everything that we do, let it be a channel from the Father, and we act. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's not go and we try to act up. We are apostles, we are prophets, we are everything. Let us not let these titles, they are from God after all.
Yeah.
Like excite us because of the things that are happening. But let's go and we rely on God, and that's then we're gonna experience breaking of protocols. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's then we're gonna experience his fullness. Because everything that we'll be doing, it will be coming from him, we act. Coming from him, we talk. Coming from him, we do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the next point is it's faith. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Faith. If I don't talk about this, I wouldn't have done justice to myself. Because this scripture, it does something to me. It's I don't understand. The man Jesus, that guy, he was just something else. When we go to the Bible in the book of Mark 11, it talks about Jesus going. He was going from Bethany to, is it Jerusalem or what? Something like that, where he was hungry and he went to a fig tree. He went to a fig tree to check if there were. He went there not to check, but to get something, only to find that they were none. And you know why? It was because it was not time for figs. The Bible says it very well. It was not the time for the tree to give. You get my point? But the man Jesus went there and maybe like, you know what, tree? Just because you didn't give me what I was looking for, you just have to die. Jesus, what kind of an authority do you have? If it is not in my time, what am I supposed to do?
Amen.
Like you get my point? The tree was just, it was just commanded, and it just had to. You get it?
Amen.
And it was, if it was a human, then she was gonna complain, like,
yeah.
But it's not my time. Maybe if it was about salary or something. I'm not paid yet, so what am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
But Jesus expected something from you. Like, you get it?
Yeah.
That's the kind of faith that we need to have.
Yeah.
Like, okay, I didn't submit a CV. I went there anyway.
Mm.
I went there anyway because I want this post. I want it.
Yes.
I want it.
Oh, yeah.
I just didn't get time to type the CV. you see, I just went there with faith that, you know what, I am the right man for the job. So they're going to have to take me. The authority that I have doesn't allow them to not submit.
Mm.
You get it?
Amen.
But that's the thing that Jesus used. On the fig tree, it was not yet its time, Shep. It was not its time to give figs. But he just went there looking for figs, and he didn't get it. The man was hungry. And when you disappoint me, you just say, with the authority that I have, I don't care. You die. You get it?
Amen.
That's the kind of authority that Jesus understood that he had.
Amen.
Why? Because he knew the Father, he knew the Father, he knew that the God that I serve, protocols. He breaks, even if it's not your time, he can just command you and you submit. He is a father who, if I grab myself and it would just happen.
Oh, yes.
You would not get it. Because he is like God. Let's know this God for who he is. Let's not pretend to know him. Don't pretend to know God because of me. But go and find God for yourself. And let me tell you, he will not disappoint you. He will reveal in fullness. He will just pour it all. He will just pour it all. You will not stand it.
Amen.
You will not stand it. Why? Because he is too much. This God is too much. Let's go and we pluck ourselves. We have faith that whatever he says, it's what it is. Hallelujah. If the man was, I said calling him a man. If this supreme being was able to command things which were not, as though they are, like, you know what? He's just an I'm out of time. I am out of time, and there are a lot of things that I wanted to speak about. I wanted to like you get that thing. Get it? That you have to know God. You have to know yourself in Him. You have to use that which He says use, and I will respond. The Bible says that there is no man who can please God without faith. If I have faith, please, man. He's just pleased. That's why.
Amen.
Jesus commanded, and he had faith, and God was pleased, and he was like, okay, tree just died. you understand? Yes, because Jesus had faith, and he understood.
Yes.
And he knew himself in him.
Yeah.
This God is just too much. Let's go and we know this God.
Hallelujah.
And let me tell you, we are going to experience his glory in this term, the next term, going forth. We are going to experience the total achievement. We are going to experience his grace. We are going to experience his fullness. We are going to experience him in our academics, our families. We are going to experience this God as the God that he is, not as the God that they say he is, but as him who he is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go and we. I wish I had time. I just wish I had time. We understand this thing until it sinks, that there is nothing that we can do if we don't know. The devil will play with our emotions. If he will play with us, he will just use us around, because we do not know. There is power in knowledge. There is power in knowing your identity. Hallelujah. So because of time, let's just stop here, and we just go and we find this God for who he is. Let's not go and really say God is just because we heard. Let's go and we experience him for ourselves. Let's go and we get the God that is supposed to be not the God of Abraham, not the God of Moses, but the God of success. You understand?
Amen.
The God of success. I can define him for myself.
Amen.
The God of success.
Amen.
Because he is my God.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm sorry. I thank you for this time. It is such an honor to stand in front of people who you know, and they know the word. They are apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and you are just an intercessor. And you get my point. It is a privilege to stand here and I speak to you. We just learn. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I thank you so much, EOC, for proclaiming me, and I am sorry for taking time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.